He loves me. He loves me not. He loves me.
He loves me.
He loves me not. He loves me.
He loves me.
He loves me not. He's just playing games. He loves me. He makes me crazy. He loves me not.
He's my best friend.
He loves me.
He's my favorite, favorite.
I don't know where he is.
Do I want to know where he is? He loves me.
This is what love is supposed to be.
Is this the way that love is supposed to be?
He loves me.
When he holds me, it feels like home. He loves me.
So why am I alone?
He loves me. He loves me.
He makes me happy.
This is not a fair letter. He's the only negative thing in my life.
You're never gonna change.
He loves me.
This is what I've been waiting for.
I don't want you to change for me.
He loves me.
I've been down, but I always get back up.
It can't get any darker than pitch black. It can only get bright again. When I was making the bridge, I was in a bubble. It was very safe and very green, naive at times. The bubble has been popped. Somebody came along with a big pin that said reality and was like, my manager Carmen turned to me and she says, okay, we gotta get, you know, started working on album number two. I felt like I had no idea what I was doing. I felt like I couldn't write. I felt like I couldn't sing. And it's amazing that when it went back to starting my second album, I had no faith in myself. Things were moving so fast for me that I barely got a chance to enjoy the experience. So I needed to take the time to tap into that and say, okay, who are you? Where are you? And what do you want to say now? People don't understand, like, and especially for me, I'm a very emotional writer. I really have to feel something to get it out and tell that story honestly. When I think about that first song that I wrote to begin this process of working on this album, it was about the pressure I felt to be, you know, what they want me to be. And I refuse to living a lie. Because I can only be what I'm destined to be. So Jack Splash was a producer that I wanted to work with from the first album. Bones is a very special record to Jack. Bones is such a sexy, sexy record. I want you so badly that I want your bones. I want more than your touch or your flesh. I want to go to the furthest, deepest depth of you. Who says that? I want your bones? Most people are like, I want your heart. I want your soul. I want your mind. I want your bones. You don't get much deeper than that. When it comes to a song like Change the Record, I love this record because it's a very matter-of-fact way to say something, using love and lovers and men and women as records. And you know, just like records, when they get scratched or they start skipping and you're in the same line, you're just like, shit, can't listen to that record anymore. If you can do better, then do better. You don't like how someone's doing something for you, to you, or the place that you're at, take your power back and change your scenario. Change your record.
If you don't like how he's playing it, change the record. You can do better. You do better. Change the record. If you can do better.
Or I am and my lover won't answer. I've been there. And so have a lot of people.
Turn the lights on.
Sitting here feeling kind of crazy.
my first album, I had been so deep into the musicality of big band, and I did have a reservation about doing that very open, very linear sound. And it was actually one of the last songs I did for the album. But by that time, I was open. And I was like, you know what? Just try it.
And I can't sit still.
He played the record for me, and I listened to those words. The words of that song were real life and very poetically done.
And he don't even care if 4 a.m. and my lover won't answer. It's probably somewhere with the dancer.
That line that, you know, I don't deserve this life. I make the perfect way. Like, I have said those exact words. I'd make the perfect wife, so why and when is it gonna happen for me?
And it's important that we live our MF lives every day. And that's what it's about. The MF life.
Said you care for me. So I can go to sleep.